time to add another type of data structure to the mix. Before we dive into maps, I want to introduce one new concept quickly. A set is another one of these broad, abstract concepts. It's comparable to a list. It's also vaguely a collection of things, but with one big difference. A list has some kind of ordering for its elements. A set doesn't have that, but instead doesn't allow for repeated elements. You can think of a set kind of like a bag. You can reach in and pull something out, but you'll never know what order you're getting the elements out in. A map is a set-based data structure, kind of like an array is a list-based data structure. The keys in a map are a set. I know that's a lot of new terminology, but let's look at exactly what that means. The keys of a map, like the words in a dictionary, need to be unique. You can have several definitions for the same word stored in the value, but if you had the same word in the dictionary many times, you would randomly pick out a definition when you were first looking. Thus, each key only exists once in a map. And a group of these unique keys without any order is called a set. So, what are maps useful for other than dictionaries? You can use a map for a lot of things that have unique names. For example, maybe you have a bunch of information about Udacity courses. You could store each course ID as a key and use that to look up more detailed information as values,